Hey guys, how's it going? It's Sean. So I'm here in Georgia in the United States and I'm meeting a good friend of mine. His name is Ryan. We actually met in Seoul, South Korea. We worked on projects together and we were just friends there.
A little bit about Ryan. Ryan has started and bought many companies and has had lots of success. He's one of the smartest, most creative, and hardworking people I've ever met. He recently sold his company, FOMO, for a lot of money, and he's currently working on many new exciting projects. He recently moved here to the US after living in Korea for around 2 years, where he met his girlfriend, Seyoung.
He was so kind to invite me to his amazing property here in Georgia in the United States, and I'm excited to give you guys a tour. This place is awesome. You're gonna love it. Let's do it.
What's up? 안녕하세요.
Hey, what's up, man?
들어오세요.
안녕하세요.
Well, welcome. This is our house. We just moved here from Seoul, Korea, yeah. Where Seyoung grew up.
Yeah, I was born in Korea and spent the whole my entire life in Korea, and then moved to Ranch.
Welcome.
In USA.
Yeah. We're now in the living room. It has a very hunter deer cabin vibe. A lot of the decor and finishes and accents have horns and different animal motifs.
Did you kill it and eat it?
I wish.
We didn't kill this much of like deers. It just came with us.
It came with the house.
It was a
welcome gift.
Yeah.
And here's our kitchen. We like to eat small meals here, lunch over here, and dinner over in the dining room. And if you look out the back, we have this pond, and this is where you could go fishing, but we don't know how to do that, so we just go feed the fish every day. And here is just another sitting area outside. There's a TV, more chairs, our grill. This is good if you're sweaty, but you want to have lunch and you don't want to come inside and make things dirty.
Out
there. Yes, if you can see, there's a duck here.
Whoa.
Woody.
Hey, buddy.
It actually lived here longer than us, so.
Yeah.
He's like, you're the new guys.
Yeah. We're the intruders.
The Odia's dream.
He's like, yeah, you guys look
new
here.
Bad guys.
This first garage is our gym. So dips, pull up, push up, simple exercises, right? You can do this kind of thing. So it's a great place to work out and not get injured. Down the hallway on the left, we have an oversized laundry room. Maybe one day this could be a baby's room.
Yeah.
Kids' room.
Okay. It's like perfect setup, like has tap, water, and everything. But yeah, it is ridiculous size for
a
laundry room.
It's like you can start a business here.
Yeah, and I mean like this whole house have a lot of storage area, even like drawers and cabinets and everything. This is whole empty right now.
Yeah.
There's just simple guest bathroom and our favorite TV show on the wall. We did the jigsaw puzzle.
Oh, nice. The office. Is this your favorite place to take a poop?
I never go here because it's because it's ceramic, it's cold, you know?
Oh, yeah. Gotta be nice to your...
Also, guest bathrooms, so we don't ruin them.
Keep it nice for guests.
Yeah.
Got it.
There's a master bedroom. Very simple.
Yes.
It'll probably stay this way for a long time.
It's not bad.
We don't have anything to do in here except sleep.
Yeah.
So we have the bed, and of course, we have a 9mm Glock in case someone tries to break in.
Got a question for you. A lot of people wondering this about Americans. They think Americans are gun crazy. Why have the Glock next to your bed?
The taste of full freedom and knowing enough history about how countries and nations are formed and reformed through civil wars. And once you understand that, you realize that having a weapon is the only way to protect your own freedoms and your local area. In America, we're encouraged by the Second Amendment to form local militias and to prevent the government from tyrannizing us. So that's what people are doing. Mm-hmm. People who hate guns fundamentally don't understand that. They just hear the news that some bad person killed people with a gun, which is super unfortunate, but good guys also kill bad guys with guns. And the best way to kill a bad guy with a gun is with a gun. So it's a double-edged sword. That's what freedom is. That's the cost of freedom, that's the benefit of freedom.
Double-edged gun.
Double-edged gun, there you go. So having practicing good gun safety is obviously important.
Huge. Well said. Master bedroom, everybody.
Master bathroom.
Master bathroom.
We've got the two sinks set up, his and hers.
Nice.
People call them that.
Do you often find yourself using the sink at the same time?
Yes.
So it is useful.
Yeah, man.
Once you wake up, you know, I do my thing. I have my gummy vitamins.
Nice.
And then brush my teeth, that's it. And then you know how women are, they do 80 things, and so all of this is full with junk.
No, not true.
Is this true?
No, not true.
Not true, okay.
It's like relatively full, you know?
Yorkshire.
So this is the real bathroom.
Yeah. This is some kind of jets that make you think you're in a river stream, but we haven't tried it yet. Here we've got the shower with some more jets.
Oh, so this is your shower, right? It's one you use. This is cool, man.
This is the boys' closet. So I have my simple things. Very easy. Easy life. Shirts, underwear, shorts. That's it. And lastly, we have the woman's closet over here.
It's ridiculous size, I know.
Well, so this is Seyoung's.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. It's
wow, it's nice.
It's far away from fully prepared, so I don't know. People say it will be soon, like we'll fill it with clothes.
It's bigger than my place in Seoul.
Yeah, it's messy.
Many people will probably relate to what I just said.
Very interesting. All right, now we go.
Where the magic happens.
The basement. When we come down the basement, the first thing we walk into is the bar, cafe, game room area. We come here every day to make coffee in the morning, start reading books, and getting ready to work that day. But then at night, of course, we can have different types of drinks. There's a fridge, another ice machine, and espresso, everything we need. Over here, we have the hangout area, starting with the pool table when you don't want to do anything with technology. And we have this cool 48-star flag. Of course, there's 50 states, but the 48-star flag represents all the states except New York and California because we don't like those places.
Okay.
And here's the kind of gaming area. We've got some guitars on the wall. We've got some Korean snacks. What are these called?
Yakgwa.
Yakgwa. This actually represents my time in Korea when I was in entertainment.
Yeah.
This is when I was in San Francisco in tech startups. This is when I was in New York. And here's how I started my life in the suburbs. And now I'm kind of all the way back in the house. So this was the prologue, the beginning of my life story.
Battery.
Oh, battery.
Just chilling.
And lastly, over here, we have the safe. Which is some guns and more guns, ammunition, scopes, red dot, holsters, earplugs, eye protection wear, cases, passport.
Oh, you have a passport?
Yeah. 여권도 있고, everything you would want.
Yeah, this is where you don't want people to come.
Right.
This is where you hold your valuables. You're showing me this gun yesterday.
Right, this is the Beretta 9mm.
Yeah, wow, these are real guns. They have a really cool feel to them.
Yeah, that one's a really good size.
Yeah, zombies come, you're not scared.
Not until we run out of all of the bullets.
Okay. We're gonna try those later.
We're gonna try those later.
Yeah, and
couple more rooms.
That's fine.
We have the library. This is where we read every morning. It's good for studying, just thinking. We have the books I've read over the years, and now Seyoung has also started a collection.
Very cool.
Some English, some Korean.
It's like a little cafe in here.
Yeah, we wanted to create a cafe vibe. This is my office.
Would you say you spend most of your time in this room?
Definitely.
Most? I'm trying to work Monday through Thursday and stop around 4:30 or 5 p.m.
How did you get to Korea and how did you meet Seyoung?
I went to Korea because I wanted a change of pace. I didn't want to sit on a computer all day and work in technology anymore. So I moved to Korea to pursue my childhood dream of music. And I got to Korea, I hired some tutors, I started learning Korean language, I wrote and recorded an EP, so a 5-song album in Korean. I performed some shows, I did a bunch of TV and radio and competitions, and those all went really well. But ultimately, I decided I wanted to go back to the US and do what I'm best at, which is, I guess, technology and entrepreneurship. But along the way in Korea, I met Seyoung actually at a cafe. We were both just standing in line and we started talking. First we started being friends, then we started working together on my YouTube, vlogs, film, media career, and then we started dating. And so when I decided to come back to the US, obviously she was invited, and now we're both here enjoying this very different lifestyle from Seoul, New York City, San Francisco, or LA, Atlanta, where I used to live. Some Korean things, 아리랑 상장. 노래가 좋아, 앙코디랑 TBS 라디오 백종원 클래스. Let's go to your office.
Yeah, this is mine. Sorry for not organized, ignorance.
It's all good. No worries.
So I don't, like, try not to forget about Korea. So just prepare every time in my office.
Don't forget.
Anyway, so this is my office, which is your workplace. Usually I sit here working. And sorry for the mess.
All good.
Very messy. And I got this big poster printer. You can print the widest this length is 36 inch. You know, as a girl, mirror, like very essential. So I grew up in Daejeon, which is a very famous area for all those academies, hagwons. So I started in a very young age, I guess in my age 5, I started learning English. So that's why I think I get fluent with it. And after that, I went to school. So I became somehow majoring in art design. First I met Ryan was my fourth grade, my last year of university, and he showed me his like different project, and I said, I want to design those stuff with you. I want to be part of it. So we made different, like I helped him YouTube video, and then we made a board game, we did an NFT project, all this stuff. I just raised my hand and I said, I want to do it. So when first Ryan suggested me to, we want to go US with me together, then I said, why not? Like, I don't have to work in Korea because I can remote working. I can choose my time to work because I'm freelancing. So
that's Uri Jeep. That's our crib. Work in progress. We've been here 2 months and we've had some traveling in between. So this is 60 days into the setup, but later we'll drive around the property and we'll shoot some guns.
Cool. Sounds good.
Yeah.
All right.
Ciao. Look at that, none of mine were above. I'm trending down. So like categorically I need to adjust how I aim. Huh. Yeah. My score, we'll count later.
Kinyum boom.
It's already ready to go. Nothing to do except turn off safety.
Am I just standing here?
Yeah.
That thing really gives a kick. Holy moly. All right.
Well, sir.
This is not my gun.
It's not your fault, though.
This is not my gun.
But we literally don't know how to calibrate the sight. Seriously, we have no idea.
This is not the gun for me. You mind if I shoot a few shots at the other one?
Yeah,
so
yeah,
I don't look so
keep the same
terrible?
Target. Okay. Keep the same target. How about keep the same target?
All right, let's try an easier gun.
Keep the same target. Do 8 shots, because you got 2. That way you can have max 10 points just like us. And then we'll count.
This man is a smart man. Yeah, smarter than he looks. Just kidding. This is my redemption. My redemption opportunity. Here we go. It was the gun. It was the gun. It wasn't me. All right, guys? Okay.
여덟 개만 남았습니다. Safety on.
Yeah.
Hugging.
Hugging.
A lot more hits. A lot more hits. The AK just needs a calibration.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I hit them all except for one.
Wow.
So much better, but still shitty, but much better.
Very good.
It was the gun, but time also me. I want to say to everybody that a big reason why I'm showing this in this video, you know, guns and shooting guns, is because it's kind of a big part of American culture, and especially Georgia, where I'm in right now. To Americans, it's really important to be independent and self-sufficient. That means, you know, having your own car, having your own animals, having your own farm, and having your own guns. You're autonomous. It's easy for non-Americans to see this and be scared and confused by it, and I get that. And I don't, by any means, condone any cruel or evil use of guns to kill innocent people. I don't condone that. But I just wanted to show you this slice of life, this slice of culture that does exist in the United States. All right, everybody, thank you so much for watching this video. Did you enjoy it? If so, please let me know in the comments down below. Also, if you're currently studying English, I highly recommend you join my channel membership. All right, everyone, I'll see you next time. Bye.